Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie. I'm glad you guys could join us. Actually, join me. And typically, my wife is with me, helping me to video. She's the videographer of the team, and she's busy right now taking care of some things at home. We've got some company coming for dinner, so you're gonna have to stick with me. All right, now on to the video. Okay, what we're gonna do today is, this is another part of the series, Keeping Clean in the Woods, and the feet. All right, now what we're gonna do here, to see how to wash your feet, how to clean your feet, I'll recommend that you watch the other video in the Keeping Clean in the Woods series called Body Washing, or Washing Your Body, something like that. That'll show you how to wash. One way that we typically use to wash when we're out in the woods. Okay, so let's say you've got your feet clean now. Now you want to you want to deodorize your feet and help them to not get bacterial growth, fungal growth. All right, this is what I have found to be very effective. Okay, this is usnea, or usnea. All right, now, like I've shown in some of my other videos, it grows on spruce trees around here, poplar trees, willow, alder, cottonwood. It's a lichen. All right, to use it, you just pluck it off. How you can identify that it's usnea is to pull it apart. It's got a central stem to it that runs throughout with branches on it, and pull it apart. Okay, that's kind of hard to see, but there's little, hopefully you can see that, there's little white thread inside of it. There's many different varieties of usnea, so it's fairly widespread and available to quite a bit of the public. Of course, this should go without saying, have permission. If you're on private property, it might be a good idea to get permission to collect it. All right, and this is how I use it on athlete's foot or fungus problems. Okay, we'll just pretend that these are my feet. And this may not work very good right now because there's quite a little breeze blowing. But usnea has a powder to it. All right. Now, in order to get that powder off of it, of course, it needs to be dry, so you want to collect this while it's dry, or else collect it and then dry it and before you want to use it. Okay, hold it over your toes and just work it back and forth like this. Just work it, work it, work it. Yeah, we're getting some good powder off of it here. Good. Just work it over your toes. Like that. Okay, hopefully you can see there's green all over my, you know, there's other debris there too, but there's just kind of a green haze over my fingers here. All right, you'll take that and rub it into your, in between your toes like this. Rub it in between each toe. Like that, rub it in real good. If you have open cracks, that as a result from fungal growth, rub it into the cracks. It'll help to heal those cracks. And then after you've got it thoroughly rubbed in, I go ahead and dust my toes again. Dust them real well. Get a good coating of dusting on your toes. in between your toes like that. And then I, hopefully you can see that. And then I pulled my socks on right over that. And if I've got athlete's foot, typically only one or two applications of the Usnea will take care of that athlete's foot. And if you're playing this regularly, like you're out on the trail and you're getting wet feet quite a bit crossing creeks in the rain and going through wet brush and stuff, well, this will hopefully help keep you from getting fungal outgrowth on your feet. It'll help keep your feet deodorized and help you from getting athlete's foot. Well, I hope you learned something, and I'm really glad that you guys joined me. Thanks for joining me, and we'll see you on the next video. You guys take care.